So quickly going to pull out some of the more obvious elements of X-Men First Class. Obviously follows the 500 Templar Stage Hero journey pattern. Let's go over basic story architecture first. So when you first start writing and filmmaking, you have a linear perspective in that sense. Pretty soon you realize that both the beginning and the end are the same, which is why we demonstrate story structure via a loop. Lots of ways of looking at this. I often use a state of perfection. Originally it's possessed, it's lost, and the process of returning to it is undergone. I often throw in the concept of capacities. Initially, the capacity to maintain a state of perfection is possessed. The capacity is lost, and the process of regaining capacity in order to be able to return to it is undergone. The process involves lots of major stages and lots of micro stages. And when I say micro, I don't mean to imply they're unimportant or less important. It's just a method of grouping that allows us to make demonstration easier. You can look at the micros as stepping stones, or you can look at the micros as elements within self-contained processes that must be completed before movement forward is allowed. So we've got classic beginnings where you start at the state of perfection, or alternative beginnings where you start at the state of imperfection. Lots of successful stories start there, and in that instance what happens there is compacted early on and or referenced at later stages in specific places. The whole process is a metaphor for maturity, growing up, and a number of other things, and the whole process is described using a number of metaphors, symbols, representations, etc. So let's get rid of that, and let's draw a loop. So we know now there's much more behind that loop than a simple circle represents. So in X-Men First Class, what we have is a state of imperfection, classic inciting incident symbolism. Eric loses his mother, and then Shaw kills her, so we've got a great antagonism that needs to be contained. We haven't got the capacity to do that at the moment, but we're going to go through the journey and gain those capacities, confront that antagonism at the end, and suppress it, contain it, extinguish it. We've got a devolved state, so Raven says, we're mutant, but we're not really proud. We're going to go through the journey, gain the capacity to be mutant and proud, so gain a form of maturity. As per the classic pattern, the journey doesn't start really until the hero or various archetypes on the cusp of adulthood, so we wait until both Xavier and Eric are young men. Then we've got the Herald magical gift, so Eric goes to the bank and gets Shaw's location. We've got the call to adventure, so the CIA agent needs somebody with specific skills and capacities, so she pulls out Xavier from his ordinary world. He's at university, he's just graduated, he's about to become a professor, get a job, embark on in the adult world. So again, references to maturity there. Pulls him out, we've got new world, first threshold. Eric goes to Argentina, I think. We've got the standard battles there, have performed their standard functions. We've got detachment, so we've got the CIA realizing that mutants do exist because Raven shows the true self. We've got Major Threshold Guardian battle, so the battle with Shaw on the boat, the initial failure to contain him, to capture him, or to hook onto the submarine. So another measure of the devolved self, which we evolve from, and we gain the capacity to do that later while we when Eric pulls the whole submarine out of the water. Physical separation, Xavier jumps in and saves Eric, pulling away from the older self. Eric realizes that he's not alone. Suddenly we're entering a deeper new world, so now we've become the CIA's mutant division. We've got supernatural aids, meeting Hank, right? We've got a magical gift, so this device that helps us locate all the mutants, which in essence is the elixir. We've got the road of trial, so going and persuading all the mutants to join us. We're going all the way around, classic stages, seizing the tangible sword. So we go in to a dangerous domain, dangerous world to rescue or to capture Emma Hunt. We've got classic stages preceding that, dragon battles, wolf clothing, so making himself invisible, or making the whole everybody in the truck invisible. Going forward to the maturity phase, the containment stage, and now we've got to gain capacities, and that is demonstrated by growth. One demonstration is the boon, where Eric becomes the full-blown beast. We've got atonement, so that's the Kennedy speech, gives us time pressure into to resolve the this state of affairs, pulls us into the final conflict. So the standard battles between all the superheroes, X-Men, hand-to-hand battle. So we've got Eric confronting Shaw, containing him, extinguishing him, destroying him, suppressing him. Brings us back round to our state of perfection. We've got Departure, where Eric splits from Xavier. We've got the mature self, so Eric now wants to be called Magneto, so we've matured. Also, from the original deficient state point of view, we were mutant originally and we were not proud. Now we've come full circle and we are mutant and proud. So that's a very, very basic pullout of X-Men First Class. It's a lot more detailed than that. If you want a detailed deconstruction of that story, you can order it off the website, but you definitely need to get your head around the 510 plus stage hero's journey, which covers the pattern that all successful stories follow.